once again, and ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our next session, An Eye for the Customer. Our next speaker, he has been with Kansai Nerolac since 1998 and brings with him over two decades of sectoral experience. Now, while in Kansai Nerolac, he has held a variety of roles in the sales and marketing domain, and currently he holds the role of Vice President, Sales and Marketing at Kansai Nerolac Decorative Paints since October 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together to welcome Mr. Ram Mehrotra, Vice President, Decorative Sales and Marketing, Kansai Nerolac.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks a lot to Exchange for Media for giving this opportunity to share some thoughts with so many marketing professionals around. From complete e-commerce, I bring it my presentation to an industry where probably e-commerce is still a distance at a very large, big difference. And we had been trying, but probably Ravi can help us out in future. But then this industry, there is very low differentiation. The involvement of the customers is very, very low. And when the paint actually gets applied on the wall, nobody can make out which brand it is. So that kind of challenges are there with the industry. And with that, we found probably still for our consumers, the entire efforts from our marketing team has been how to create convenience for the consumer so that he can at least get, because earlier probably the information itself was a big challenge, but with digital coming in, a lot of information for the consumers to take a decision has been created. So maybe I thought, let me share some of the things and come to an eye for the customer. Now, typical classical marketing mix, we know that product, price, place, promotion, but then there's an important eye in between for us in this industry when we talk about paints. Now, in terms of a typical marketing decision-making process, we say there's a seller, then there's a buyer, and the seller sells to the buyer directly. But then in some of the industries, there are users, and then a come in between an influencer. This influencer plays sometimes two types of role. If he plays the role of a, say, advocate, probably goes well because he's helps in terms of, say, convincing the consumer to go for a particular brand. It helps in conversion. Whereas if he acts as a gatekeeper, then it becomes a problem, then very difficult to break the jinx. And I'm sure my colleague Vivek was talking about Pidilite, and he was talking about the contractors. Very difficult to actually convert then the customers when the influencer says this is the best brand, because they are seen as the doctors. They are seen, they know far better than what we know because of the lack of information. Now, if I talk about, so this is the eye which we want to keep an eye upon, very, very important for our industry. And they are the key to any brand success when we talk about the paints. Now, influencers can be of three types. One is the global one, where you have a celebrities with mass appeal, so you are able to connect with the consumers, give them that brand perspective, or through their reach, you ride on that and reach to a large chunk of customers. The other platform which is coming up big time is the social platform. So social platform is becoming a big influencer, and it will further increase upon in the years to come because it creates a very positive word of mouth, and therefore a lot of people in various groups, they exchange about various brands and all. So those information, they become, it's a very, very important thing. But what I would be covering is the part which is the local influencer, which does the maximum amount of conversion. So this is the person who does that entire, the last point mile when the consumer is about to take a decision about which brand to use. This plays a role and tries and convert that customers. So it can be an associate, it can be a employee, so with a limited set of influence. And within this eye, we have like used digital part to actually get on to them, what all we have done. I'll just share a few slides on that. So we expect that from an influencer, generally the expectation is that reach, relevance, and the resonance. So there's a following, there's a relevance with the brand, and which resonates with it. Now, to give you a glimpse of the paint industry, it's almost about 40,000 crores in the current year, which is the kind of organized and unorganized and decorative segment which I'm talking about. And the trend shows that it is moving towards more of a premium products. And when it comes to premium, there's a lot of, like, the role of influencers become more and more critical. Like, if it is a small decision where the, or for a product which is at a very, very low cost, the decision is directly taken or left onto the influencer or taken by the consumer, bring this. The mother brand acts as a very, very important there. But when it comes to the involvement of money becomes more, the products are more premium. So probably there, the shift is happening more towards premium, and therefore the role of influencers is also getting more and more critical. Now, if I talk about the industry, in last 4-5 years, the consumer engagement from 8% has gone to 39%. So a lot of engagement in terms of consumer getting into this category. So they still go with the influencer, but then engagement is happening because a lot of information now is available with the consumers. And any house, so whosoever is going for a house makeover, paint is a very, very important part. But that, then it comes at the end when all other things are purchased and then left on to the painters, which is the entire look of the house, which is going to give to any of the, like, for them or the visitors, is left on to a painter for that sake. Now, typically, as I told you, probably the movement is happening towards premiumization, and therefore, the in terms of the buyers, they are also seeking more and more information before taking that call. So if I talk about key in terms of sources of information, from where does the consumer today source information other than the digital? Digital, so we have websites, we have various engagement things from where the consumer can get information about the product. But then the comparisons, actual demonstrations, all those things are missing. And as I told you, e-commerce is at a distance because of this important eye. The today, in terms of paint, can be made available. It can be sold through the, e-commerce. But then the thousands of colors, so we would be having, say, 24,000 colors. So to create that color and to show that on a mobile or a TV screen, the colors vary. So they choose and there's a differentiation there. So a lot of complexity in terms of choosing the colors and also the logistics which comes in to deliver those colors. So therefore, the source of information, again, remains on the friends and the painters as of now. And the reliability of source, and when we go about the reliability part, the consumers still go on to the painters or the dealers, which recommend them the brand. And based on that, most of the buyers are able to take a decision. Now, challenges that we face on the influencer level is, one, the education level is low, which is more or less same with the contractors for the adhesives that we are talking about. It's a migrating population. Like, most of the people will be from one or two, say, states, which migrate all across, and they don't stay there for long. They have an instant noodle kind of a mindset, large chunk, although there are loyalty programs to retain them, but then what is the instant thing, what you are offering as compared to the other brands? Based on that, some shift happens. They are more or less transactional, though all industry makes an effort to create that emotional loyalty, but then still the mass chunk remains transactional. And then cost per contact is very, very high as we compare to other mediums which are available through which we can reach to our consumers, but then reaching to them, the cost per contact is very high. And this has led that the spends on the influencers has almost gone 3 times. If I take our examples on also, like from a 6% kind of a spend, today we are spending almost 18-20% of our marketing spends on this important thing, which is called an eye, that is influencer. Now, for the key levers on which the most of the competitors play upon when they talk about the influencer management. The one is they need that one-stop solution. They need everything, if whatever they want in terms of information, various kinds of products. So in terms of, so that is one thing which they are looking up to when they are looking at any paint company. And then we have to keep our communication simple, because as I told you, probably the education levels are still not that high, and therefore the very, very simple communication has to go. And the simple question is, what's in it for me? That's the basic question that they keep in mind, and they require keep meeting. So to give a reminder, and keep meeting is, again, as I told you, cost per contact is becomes higher, because you have to be in regular in touch with them, because there are other competitors also, and you have to be in touch so that you create that remembrance. Now, if we talk about this particular eye, what we have done in various areas to ensure that there's a complete connect with the painters. So at the various touch points, so if there's a dealer, so there are POSs, there are various draws, lucky draws, which happens around these influencers. Then training programs and product trials are done on a regular basis. So we have a list wherein these painters are touched upon as far as the training programs are concerned. Then we have developed an app for these painters, wherein they can get the product information, they can get the cost estimates, even the loyalty program which we are talking about, they can enter their points and they can upload their points. So those kinds of things which are like in terms of a loyalty building, and then giving them the remuneration for that. Then in terms of, there are digital, even radios getting connected, which is only for the influencers. So through digitally, they can download the app, and that their songs and whatever they can play through. So those kinds of things keep in an eye for these influencers. Then regular interactions with the sales team, so that connect is there. And then mobile van training or tokens inside, so that they are ensured every time occupied, load, and also connected with the company in various forms. And various activities that we have done to connect with these influencers, other than, as I said, digital. One is the connecting with their families is going a level below, wherein arranging mailers for them, where can their families can come, and the brand goes beyond the painters which is using, and some connect can be created with the family. Then there's a premium painter loyalty program which happens for them. Then there's a Pradhan Mantri Vikas Yojana, wherein they are, through NSDC certification, we do that certification kind of a training program for them. And they get as he said, identity is very, very important, whether FCC or, say, that certificate from the Pradhan Mantri, that kind of a thing, NSDC certifying it. So that also helps in terms of building up the connect with the influencers. Then tokens, and then for the convenience of the consumers, we have created something called Master Painter, where a consumer can go and select the area where they can find the painters. So they get the painters with reference photographs. These are the sites that they have done. They can select a painter, because that's one big challenge when we talk about e-commerce, because the paint can be delivered to them, but how about the painter? And when the painter comes in and he is not satisfied with the brand, and or he has not used the brand earlier, because this still remains a very habit buying industry, and painters have been using a particular brand for years. So when they find a separate brand already there in the house, generally they tend to reject, and they say, I won't take any guarantee if it goes wrong. And then the consumer is confused, and the decision goes in a different direction. So that's the one of the the criticality of the industries, which probably I thought in a very short span I can share with you the trends which are there available with us, whether per capita consumption increasing or the paint industry is one of the industry which is, for last, I would say, 3 decades, never the industry has grown below double digit. So in spite of whatever last year or this year, generally the trend is they have grown by that double digit. So in the industry continue to perform well. Consumers are continuously seeking inspirations, a lot of information. But then when it comes to taking a decision, they have to rely on a person who is not that educated. And generally, they base their decision based on the influencer recommendation. So role of the influencer is going to increase with this, because when the premium purchases and all those things are, the economy is moving upwards, the eye, this consumer is going to be very, very important. In a way, influencer is an eye for the consumer because it's a both ways. For us, he is helping us in terms of getting the brand used by the or applied or at the customer side. And from the consumer side, he is a kind of a advocator, or he tells or gives a lot of information, passes a lot of information to the consumer on the basis of which he is able to take a informed decision. So I think that's all from me. Keep an eye for the influencer, more related to our industry. And we look forward that this e-commerce thing and how those things can be managed. Digital spends and digital lot of activities we have done, but still that directly getting on to the consumer still remains at a distance for us. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mehrotra. Before I let you go, I'd like to invite Mr. Harjot Nagpal, Associate VP West Kinetic, to kindly join me on stage to present a token of our appreciation to Mr. Mehrotra.